When did you join? A while ago, you were not there in the class. Coming to here. So when this technique was easy, why did we take the pain of solving it in vector form? This is much more simpler, right? This technique is much more simpler compared to the vector form. Then why don't we do this always? The thing is, in case of symmetric cases only, or in some simple situations only, this technique will work. If you are in some complicated three-dimensional space and you represent the forces and solve in this manner, assume that I place the on a cube, okay, on the vertices of a cube or a tetrahedron, then can we employ this technique?
No, so then we can't directly use something like result and equal to the cos theta.
Yes, that's the reason why we must learn vector form. Okay, because this is the first time you are watching at this vector form. So you may feel that this is difficult. Okay, you may find it difficult because this is the first time you are solving something like this. In fact, we have done such things in gravitation also, but we did not stress much on vector form. So, but here I request you all people to practice each and every question in vector form. Okay, so initially it may appear to be lengthy and difficult, but you see, because I was explaining to you people, I have written all these steps in detail. If not, I would have written this directly, this one directly, and then I have to add it. Understood? So, as with practice, the number of steps can be reduced, and as well our speed and thought process will also increase. Getting the point. So I'll give you a homework and I want you to try. So assume that we have a square. Assume that we have a square. On the vertices of a square, there are some masses placed. Sorry, charges placed. So this is Q, 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 Q. Let's name this. Let's call this as A, B, C, D. So in the given case, I want what is the total force on A in vector form. So you try it. I'm just giving the answers. Here, assume that this is x-axis, this is y-axis. So you try it in vector form. So let's say each side is A. Each side is A. So this is A 0, 0, B. This will be A 0, 0, B A, 0, C A, D 0, A. So that is force on A due to B will be how much? Can you guess directly? It will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q square by a square. in minus i cap direction. Do you agree?
Minus i cap direction.
Minus i cap.
Now force from A to B. That will be how much?
Sir, the coordinates of C will be A comma A, right? Not A comma 0.
A comma A.
A comma A.
What will be the force on AD to D?
It will be minus J cap
direction. Minus J cap direction.
Squared by A square in minus J cap direction.
It's minus J cap direction, yes.
AD to C.
So will it be in minus K cap direction?
You see, if you are confused, then go for vector AD to C. So this is 0, 0 minus X K. No. Now, ASA also, you may be asked to write this. Do not use shortcuts. So 0 j cap minus ai cap plus a j cap. So that will be minus ai cap minus a j cap. So magnitude of RAC. Magnitude of RAC.
Root 2 a.
That will be root 2 a. So this is
root 2 a.
No, not. Q square by root 2 a. Whole square is
whole square. So
2a
square.
So 2a is the distance. And direction will be how much? If I write it in
minus ai cap minus
aj. Let me put cube over
here. Minus ai cap minus aj cap by root 2a.
My this will be force on a to c. That is force on a to c will be 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q square by 2a square into 1 by minus 1 by root 2 y cap minus 1 by root 2 j cap. Do you agree with that?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So when you just add all the three forces acting on.
Yes, you have to finally add all the three forces to get the total force. Total force on A is force on A due to B plus force on A due to C plus force on A due to D. And you give the final result. And if you want to say this directly, force on AD to C is in this manner. Will you say this directly if you want?
Yes.
You see, I'll generate a new diagram over here. Logic is simple. Here there are charges A, B, C, D, each of charge Q. Q, 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 Q. So let FQ square by A square is F. Let F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q square by A square. So force on A due to B is F, this is F. So as a result of this, and here there is one more thing. So as a result of it, what we can say? F and F, if they are having 90 degrees, so what will be the result? That will be root 2 F. Is that right? Here there is F, here there is F. That will simply be root 2 F will be the resultant. Is that right? Now, what do you know about the force on A due to C? Force on A due to C, that will be how much? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q square by root 2a whole square, right? Root 2a whole square will be 1 by 2, so that is nothing but simply F by 2.
Okay.
So here F by 2 will be in this direction. So this will be F by 2. So root 2f plus f by 2 combined, what will be the resultant wave? Resultant force on A will be force on A due to B plus force on A due to D plus force on A due to C. So this is root 2f plus f by 2. So that will be root 2 plus 1 by 2 into f. तकलीफ. Did you get the point?
Yes.
That's our answer. So if you want to put it in better form, what it should be? Actually, if you solve for it, you should get something like this. Root 2 plus 1 by 2 into f is 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q square by a square in direction, that is minus 1 by root 2 I cap, minus 1 by root 2 j cap. So this must be our final answer. So try to show this. So try for a hexagon also. So it's up to you. You take some different shapes, random shapes, randomly you put the charges and try to calculate the force in vector form. So I'm sharing the PDF of volume 2 of H.C. Verma. So today what you do is that in page number 104, okay, the electric field and potential topic is given. So in that there are some questions. Okay, the idea of electric field, electric lines of force, we'll do that in tomorrow's class. Okay, there will be some simple questions based on it. So there are some worked out examples. You try them, whichever are involving force. Okay, all those questions which involve force, you try them. And in exercise, solve first 20 questions.
Sorry, sir?
First 20 questions.
Okay,
sir. Okay, sir.
So is the class over?
Yes, class is over. Yes, you can try first 20 or even 25 questions also. Okay, I'll post it in the group.
Thank you, sir.
First 25 questions. Thank you.
Okay. So thank you.
Thank you.